Do not miss out on these 5 secrets for amazing rewards so that you can have a better experience in Genshin Impact. There are several achievements in the game which are hidden from the player and will only show up once you complete them. The first one can be unlocked if you have 4 characters of the same element. Choose any domain you want, no matter what difficulty level it is, and just simply finish the trial. And you won't even need to spend any resin to claim the rewards, as the achievement will just simply show up and reward you with the Fantastic Four achievement. The second one can be easily done without any requirements. All you have to do is to keep dashing for 15 seconds. And the trick to this achievement without any preparation would be to simply keep jumping after your stamina runs out. With this cheerful performance, you will unlock the Run Helios achievement. Finally, you can get 2 achievements in a single attempt by gliding a long distance for more than 80 seconds. And the easiest way to do this would be to have your stamina maxed out and have someone like Amber or Venti in your party who can reduce your gliding stamina consumption. Now jump from the Star Snatch Cliff towards a small island you see in a faraway distance and just relax and keep gliding until you reach the ground. Once you reach it, you will get 2 achievements, and if you still haven't completed it, you can do the secret quest found on the island. There are a couple of battle pass quests that can get a little annoying to complete. The first one is a daily quest where you need to mine 10 ores, which is something that you can actually skip by simply collecting the ores from your expeditions instead. And this counts towards your daily pass quest, and what's even more interesting, you can complete the quest by actually purchasing the ores from various sellers as well. But the most painful quest of them all, especially for those who are past adventure rank 30, is the weekly quest to complete 20 leyline deposits. And while leyline deposits are great to do until adventure rank 20, they become meaningless until you get around adventure rank 45, when they start giving out pretty massive rewards. But there's a secret to completing this quest without spending any resin. You can still activate each of the leyline deposits in the 2 regions, fight all the monsters, and once it's over, it will still count towards your progress of completed leyline deposits for the weekly battle pass quest. And what's even better, you get to keep all the monster materials that drop during the fight. Just keep in mind, since you don't activate these deposits with resin to collect the reward, you will only be able to do this 4 times per day so that those unopened deposits can reset the next day. There's a secret underground cave that's occupied by hilly churls. Teleport to this waypoint and travel all the way into the mountains to this exact location. There you will find a well-hidden area that you will need to jump down to and clear out all the residing hilly churls. Once you're done, 3 chests will get revealed in a small chamber which you can enter by breaking the wooden boxes blocking its entrance. And while we're still on the same subject on things below ground level, you can get a chest from the popular Wangshu Inn. After teleporting to it, jump down and glide towards the watermill where you will need to swim under the structure and activate the cryo token for an easy, exquisite chest reward. During your travels, you might have noticed you have these nameless treasures in your backpack. There's a secret quest you can complete by collecting 3 of these items. The first one can be found in Dunyu Ruins, where you will notice a chest being protected by a huge barrier, which you can disable by completing a puzzle in this area. The second chest can be found in the Lingchu Pass, where you will need to rescue a quest giver trapped in a cage. After saving her, she will tell you about a hidden chest location which will have a nameless treasure inside of it. Finally, the third nameless treasure can be found at the Qingshu Pool, where you will need to interact with a tombstone and use a geo-elemental skill to start the mini puzzle. And once you're done with all these 3 locations and collected the nameless treasures, head on over to the souvenir shop in Liyue and wait until 9 o'clock. Now go and talk to the shop owner, and a new special dialogue option will show up where you'll be able to exchange the 3 nameless treasures for a total of 100,000 Mora and 40 Primo Gems. Completing all of these secrets can be a little exhausting, so rewarding yourself with a couple of treasure chests will fix this situation. One chest you can find in the Guyun Stone Forest. Just climb on top of these boats and smash the rubble of rocks. It couldn't get more simple than this. But probably one of the strangest chests you will find in the game is by standing on a dead branch. You can locate this branch by visiting the Dunyu Ruins in this specific location. And all you really need to do is just simply jump on this branch and the chest will appear. And there are definitely no hints about this chest whatsoever, so this can only mean that one brave player needs to volunteer and stand on every single thing in the game. Finally, since you watched till the end of this video, here's a secret that's totally not related to chests or loot, and instead it's something more amazing. You can drag and drop your party members without needing to press any buttons. All you have to do is just hold your left click when pressing on the character, and you can move them into any other slot. Now you can go wild with all the limitless possibilities. Enjoyed the video? Make sure to subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon, and gently press the like button. If you want to stay informed on our latest Genshin Impact news, make sure to follow us on Twitter, link is in the description. Thank you for watching us.